Good afternoon, traders. It's Bill Baruch with Blue Line Futures, and it's your Midday Market Minute. You got a positive vibe moving through equity markets, trading a little bit higher on the session. Last night's Singapore Summit, positive vibe coming out of there, but not a whole lot of details on a deal side, though you're going to see North Korea work towards complete denuclearization, and the market's like that. If they didn't, we said this in the Morning Express, if they didn't, we would have seen a de-risking or a risk-off sentiment coming into this morning. That was not the case. Gold's still holding about 1,300. Treasuries are slightly lower on the session. Other than that, though, somewhat quiet after the CPI read today. It was in line with expectations, solid, maybe considered a little better than expected, but not a great report. Great would have been a 0.3% higher month over month on the core CPI, or better than the 2.2 year over year core CPI expectations. That wasn't the case. You know, some were even looking for a 1/10 positive gain month over month on the core CPI, and it came in at 2/10. So slightly better, very solid. It gives not a whole lot of look into what the Fed may do tomorrow, but they are going to hike. That is expected. It's a matter of how hawkish are they going to do it, or will they stay in line with what we've seen as a dovish sentiment more recently. Ultimately, we've been talking about it as the potentially more hawkish ECB allowing the Fed to become more hawkish than expected. So watch out for that. Equity markets, though, are in a, you know, that positive vibe from the Singapore summit, a little bit of a Fed drift, hanging in against yesterday's session highs. I think, you know, the NASDAQ right now, as I'm talking, moving higher. The Russell did hit a high. S&P still well below that major four-star resistance level, but about 0.5% below there. Watch for today. If today stalls out in the S&P against yesterday's high, we could start to see a little profit taking late in the session, just like we did yesterday. Let's move on, though. Crude oil trading well, and it's out above major three-star resistance ahead of inventory data later today. The OPEC monthly report this morning did not give much to either direction. Everybody's really waiting for next week's OPEC report. However, you had potentially higher demand for OPEC oil. And this is going to be what we're going to see more people talk about, is the spare capacity. If they raise production next week, where is that spare capacity? Where does that put the spare capacity? And in case of a disaster or geopolitical tensions, so watch out for that. It's going to start to gain more traction. This is a bullish factor for the market. We continue to close out above, say, 66.10 in the major three-star resistance level. We're going to continue to see a bid under the market, and that's what we talked about in the Morning Express. Minor resistance around 66.70 to 66.90. That's stalling there right now. We had that level in the Morning Express, but ultimately major three-star resistance is well above there. And if we can continue to hold a bid, that's within reach on maybe a solid API report ahead of EIA tomorrow. Lastly, touch on gold and the metals. Gold and silver holding really, really well, given that CPI number that came in slightly better or solid against expectations. The dollar is hanging somewhat soft. And again, we're touching these currencies with the gold and silver. The euro hanging just like gold and silver very well. This could be a little bit of a look in that even if we get a hawkish Fed, you're going to see the euro stay bid, and more importantly is if the ECB is more hawkish, and that could really drive the sentiment and the currency plays throughout the end of the week. So watch out for that. Give us a call. We're here to talk about anything moving on the board. 312-278-0500. Email us info@bluelinefutures.com. Check our website for updates. You can also sign up for a free trial of our research there. But remember, futures trading involves substantial risk of loss, and it's not suitable for all investors. Thank you.